Having said that, how do you create corpus? Let us say you have gone to some organization for grant support. Let's say your project is worth about 50 lakhs of rupees or something like that, hypothetically speaking. And they are going to support you for 3 years. In the first year, they'll give you 20 lakhs, second year give you 20, and in the last, they'll give you 10 lakhs. You can tell them that, look, you're giving us for 3 years. After that, you have an exit policy. How do I sustain this program in the years to come? So will you allow us to keep 20% of this grant towards corpus? Start negotiating with 20. They may come down to 15. At least at 10, you should be able to negotiate. Most grant makers agree to that, because they realize that at least 90% or 80% of the amount you're using for programs, and you're being very reasonable in asking, can I keep 10 or 15% to a, but then again, in that grant that comes to you, this must come in writing from the donor that, yes, out of this total grant, you may set aside 10%, 15%, 20% towards your corpus for long-term sustainability of your organization. Then it might work. But the bottom line, to repeat, corpus only with the donor's written consent, that either the whole or the part of the amount must can go to the corpus. And corpus, I repeat, is a capital receipt and not counted as income of the organization. So let us say you have received 10 donations of 1 lakh each without any direction, it is your income. But you receive 20 lakhs from someone with the direction, it is towards the corpus, goes straight into the capital. It is not counted as part of your total. Any interest that will generate 1 year later on, that becomes your income in that year of receipt.